even before election officials had formally released results of the presidential race, Soumaila Cisse reached out to the apparent winner, Ibrahim Boubacar Keita. Cisse went to Mr. Keita's house in the Malian capital Bamako to congratulate him.
President Ibrahim Boubacar Keita has won this election gracefully. It is my duty to congratulate him.
Malian citizens reacted by expressing their gratitude to Mr. Cisse for how he handled defeat. Taxi driver Boubacar Diarra said the concession could help move the country forward.
For us, it is really good because if you realize you have been beaten and you go and congratulate the other for his victory, that will make our democracy better.
In contrast, Zimbabwe's presidential election, like previous ones in that country, ended on a sour note. Losing candidate Morgan Tsvangirai and his supporters say the polling was rigged and are challenging the results in court. The winner, incumbent President Robert Mugabe, has shown little patience with supporters of his longtime rival.
Those that are depressed about losing the election can go and hang themselves if they wish so.
Richard Downey is deputy director of the Africa program at the Center for Strategic and International Studies. He says differences in the way the international community has treated the two countries had an impact on the election outcomes.
There were a lot of people invested in the international community in making Mali's election work. Whereas in the case of Zimbabwe, I think it's really a failure of the broader international community, the non-African international community, which has really seems to have reached a dead end in knowing how to deal with Zimbabwe, in knowing how to deal with a president who's absolutely determined to stay in power.
But Downey says he would be careful about holding up Mali's election as a model for its neighbors on the continent.
There's been a lot of scrutiny, international scrutiny, on this election, wanting to get things right and return the country to some semblance of normality. I think the elections are really just the first phase in what will be a very long process that will hopefully restore Mali to peace again.
He says the really tough work starts now for Mali's president-elect Keita, who will have to piece the country back together again following last year's insurgency in the north and promote national reconciliation. Pam Dockins, VOA News, Washington.